As you probably know from crime shows or movies, when we die, our bodies can become feasts for insects, vultures, and other animals. But there's another group of living things that plays a big part in how we decompose, and could help forensic scientists make sense of mysterious crime scenes. This is our necrobiome, the hordes of microorganisms that take over once we take our last breaths. I'm Anna Rothschild, and this is Gross Science. Every day, you carry with you trillions of bacteria and other microbes. Scientists call this your microbiome, and while you're alive, these guys live in harmony with your own cells. But once you, or really any animal, dies, all that goes out the window. The microorganisms, especially the ones in the gut, start breaking down the body's cells and multiplying in a process called putrefaction. To illustrate this, meet my very hungry friends, Joe and Vanessa. Essentially, the microbes spread through the body and eat it from the inside. They also produce foul-smelling chemicals and gases that inflate the body like a morbid balloon, leading to what's called the bloat stage of decomposition. At a certain point, so much gas builds up that the carcass may rupture, exposing its insides to the elements. And this is when things get interesting. Up until now, most of the microbes present were anaerobic, meaning that they like places without oxygen. But after rupture, the microbes in the body cavity become primarily aerobic, or oxygen-loving, as bacteria and fungi from the environment, along with those carried by insects and other animals, begin to colonize it. At the same time, fluid starts to purge from the ruptured corpse, which can change the pH and nutrient content of the surroundings, and thus change which microbes are hanging out near the body as well. For years, investigators have used clues from the environment to estimate how long someone's been dead. For example, larvae from different insect species tend to appear at different times. But not every body becomes a bug buffet, depending on lots of things, like the location or the weather. Bacteria, though, are everywhere, including on and inside of you. So could the necrobiome be even more useful in estimating the time of death? Well, researchers recently tested this idea in mice. Different combinations of microbes were usually present on the skin and around the body at different times after death. And the scientists found that this microbial fingerprint could be used to estimate time of death within about plus or minus 3 days. Obviously, more tests will need to be done to see if this microbial clock works as well outside of a controlled experiment or in humans with our varied microbiomes. But it's a promising first step to harnessing the power of the necrobiome in all its putrid, smelly glory. Ew, Vanessa. Want to know more about the science of death? Well, head over to It's Okay to Be Smart, where Joe explores whether animals mourn. And then visit Braincraft, where Vanessa explains how the knowledge of death affects our life. And for more gross science, hit subscribe.